Okay, today we're going to take a nice little look at an introduction to polynomial functions. This video is going to be part one of three. That way I can keep each of the videos kind of short. First off, if you are going to be looking at the algebraic form of the polynomial function, might be in factored form, might be in regular form, but you've got an algebraic equation and you're trying to determine whether or not it's a polynomial function, you're going to look at the variables, because polynomial functions have variables which are raised to whole number exponents. So that's what you're going to look at. You're going to look at all your exponents on your variables and make sure they're whole numbers, and if they are, then you know you've got a polynomial function. We're also going to take a look at the graphs of some different functions, and then we're going to determine whether or not they're polynomial functions. So you need to remember that polynomial functions of degree 2 or higher have graphs that are smooth and continuous. So your two key points there are smooth and continuous. All right, let's take a look at some algebraic equations here. Let's suppose I had something like f of x equals negative 3x to the 4th minus 2x squared, and maybe even a plus 7 on the end there. Okay, now I did put this under the column of a polynomial function. All right, it is a polynomial function. You're going to take a look at each one of those exponents, and they are whole numbers. All right, and even on the 7, all right, there's a little imaginary x to the 0. All right, so x to the 0, it's a constant. All right, this is still going to classify constants, will work in your polynomial functions. All right, so then yes, something like this, this would just be like standard form of the polynomial, so it's a polynomial function. All right, now from your standard form here, you should be able to find the degree of your polynomial function. This is in just a single variable, all right? It's in standard form, so decreasing order of those exponents. All right, when it's in standard form, all you have to do is look at the leading exponent, and that's going to tell you what your degree of the polynomial is. So the degree of this polynomial is a 4, okay? Now let's take a look at an equation that is in say factored form. So maybe something like f of x is equal to maybe 3x to the 4th, and then maybe x minus 2, and then an x plus 4, let's say squared. Alright, so this is an equation, okay, in function form, and it's been factored. This is factored form of a polynomial function, because I've got an exponent 4, exponent of 2, I also have an imaginary exponent of 1 right there, so all of them are whole numbers. Alright, so let's write down that this is factored form, because this one was standard form, this one is factored form. Factored form is going to, later on, it's going to let you easily find the solutions to this equation, or the zeros when we graph it. All right, so factored form is a really nice form to work with. All right, now on this one, because it's in factored form, you find the degree in a different way. All right, you need to take each of the exponents and add them up. All right, so I have an exponent of 4, I have an exponent of 1, I have an exponent of 2. All right, that's going to give me a total of 7. So for this one, the degree is 7. Okay, all right, now let's take a look at some equations that would not be polynomial functions. All right, how about something that looks like f of x is equal to maybe something like 3 square root of x minus 2. All right, now as that sits right there, you might not be able to initially see the exponents. All right, but anytime you've got a radical, you can rewrite that into exponential form. So I could do 3x to the 1/2 power and then minus 2. All right, well, as soon as I do that, then I see that I've got an exponent of 1/2. 1/2 is not a positive integer, all right, therefore this is not a polynomial function, okay? Let's do another one, maybe something that looks like f of x equals 1 over x squared, and then maybe plus 3x. All right, so my exponent here is just a 1, so I'm good there, but this right here, okay, I can't look at it like this. I'm going to use my laws of exponents. I'm going to move that x to the second to the top. And if you remember laws of exponents, then what that does is it makes the 2 negative. So really, I can rewrite this to an x to the negative 2 plus 3x. All right, now I can look at this and start looking at my exponents. This is a 1, so that one's fine. But this is a negative integer. It's a negative, it's an integer, and it's so therefore it's not going to work. It's got to be a whole number integer, so in other words, a positive integer. So this would be an example of something that is not a polynomial function. Okay, so you will probably, at the very beginning of any chapter that deals with polynomial functions, they'll ask you to be able to identify between the two when looking at an equation. All right, now let's take a look at our graphs here. I said that a degree of 2 or higher is going to have smooth and continuous. All right, continuous basically just means that if I can draw the entire curve without lifting my pencil, then I know it's continuous. So this one, I can draw that entire thing, all right, without lifting my pencil, so I know it's continuous. All right, smooth, all right, every time I go around, these are smooth little curves, all right, so it is smooth. So this is definitely a polynomial function. Okay, now for this graph over here, all right, well, continuous, all right, clearly not continuous, because if I draw this portion of the graph, I have to lift my pencil, come over here, and draw the rest of it. So right off the bat, it's not continuous. If it's not continuous, then it's not a polynomial function. All right, but let's, I put a couple things in here. I put both of these in here so that we could see it. All right, the not continuous part is coming into play right there, and that is commonly called a jump. All right, because I had to jump my pencil. It's kind of like you drew this and you jump your pencil and then come down here. So that's a jump. All right, makes it not continuous. Now, the not smooth part. All right, this part is very, very smooth. And actually, right in here and right in here, it's smooth. The part that is not smooth is that little point right there. That point is called a cusp. All right, so if you've got a cusp, if you had only a cusp, then it would not be a polynomial function. If you had only a jump, like this part was smooth over here and then this part was smooth over here, but you had the jump in there, any one of those two things will make it not a polynomial function. So this is not a polynomial function. All right, so really easy to tell whether the graph is a polynomial function or not. All right, so just nice short little introduction here. This is part 1 of 3. So if you would like some more information about polynomial functions, be sure to check out video number 2 and video number 3. Thanks for watching, and if you liked it, go ahead and give me a like.